Hey guys, it is Paul from Wondershare MobileTrans and welcome back to another video. And today we're going to be looking at a question that we get asked quite a lot on the channel, and that is if you are able to merge two iPhones with the same Apple ID. So have two iPhones with that same Apple ID. And if you want to know the answer, make sure you keep watching right until the end of the video, because we will give you that definitive answer by the end. But if you're new here to MobileTrans, then why don't you go ahead and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any videos that we upload to this channel. And of course, while you're there, why not give it a like and hit that notification bell as well. But let's get into today's topic and today's video. So the question of today's video is, can you use the same Apple ID on multiple iPhones? And the answer to that is yes. Yes, of course you can. You can still use that Apple ID on up to 10 Apple devices at any one time. But if you do that, what you need to try and do is avoid mirroring. If you do mirroring, all that sensitive data will be exchanged between two iPhones. And also, all text messages, call histories, and all of that stuff are then accessible to the other user on the iPhone. And sometimes that's something you do not want. And one of the worst things is they can change your playlists. They might be able to log into things like Apple Music and delete some of your favorite songs, which is an absolute nightmare. So if you are using the same Apple ID on two different iPhones, and you need to go ahead and practice that isolation. And this is exactly how you would do that. First, sign in on both iPhones using that same Apple ID. Select the option Sign into your iPhone. On both devices, enter your Apple ID and password. And that is, of course, how you would then set up your Apple ID on that device. But then what about those syncing options? Well, this is how you would go about doing that. On both iPhones, go to Settings, select Apple ID, and then select iTunes and Apple Store, and then make sure you click on Disable Automatic Downloads for your apps. And now that means that you will avoid mirroring when using that same Apple ID on two different iPhones. But then what if you go onto your iPhones, the two new ones with the same Apple ID? What happens with iCloud at that point? How can you make that function separately on two different iPhones? Well, let's get into our second method of this video. When we started this video, one of the things that I mentioned was that once you use the same Apple ID, that data that is available on one iPhone will then be available on the other iPhone and another, depending on exactly how many Apple IDs you're going to have signed into the iPhones. And a way to avoid that is by unsyncing those iPhones with the Apple IDs. So there's a few different methods, so let me show you exactly what you would do to get on that. This method is to separate two iPhones via the iPhone settings. So first of all, you'll need to go into that settings app. Then open the Apple ID page by tapping on your profile. Then from the new screen, choose the iPhone you wish to unlink from the same Apple ID and then hit remove. If you're asked for a password, enter the password associated with your Apple ID or iCloud account. This will start the procedure to delete the other device's Apple ID or iCloud account. After deleting the former Apple ID, sign in with the new one on the second iPhone. What about if you want to use iTunes in your computer to unsync? Then don't worry, we have a method for that as well. So let me show you. Launch the iTunes software on your computer. Then in the Cloud tab, navigate to iTunes and select the Manage Device option. The third step is to select the iPhone from which you wish to delete the Apple ID and confirm that deletion. This procedure is the same on both Mac and Windows, and after, the Apple ID will be deleted from that associated device. A lot of the time, if you want to share certain files or information with a spouse, for example, then you would use the same Apple ID on two different iPhones. And if that is the case, then you might want to use these methods to move some of that data across two iPhones. So let me show you the first method. Apple has a natural tool for creating family groups and inviting other members to join the group so everyone can easily exchange data. To avoid using two iPhones with the same Apple ID, then just follow these next steps. Go to the settings menu, select your name, and select the option for family sharing. Turn on family sharing and ask additional family members to join the groups by following the on-screen instructions. You can also join another person's group. Furthermore, you may enable family sharing on your Mac and smoothly share between your iPhone and Mac. Even if you use an Android phone, there might be a portion of your data that you actually still want to store in iCloud. And there's a really, really easy way to make sure you can help transfer that and have people access that data by using something called MobileTrans. MobileTrans can transfer data between two phones and it enables you to exchange data with other iPhones over iCloud, regardless of the device which they are using. So if you want to download this, then go to the MobileTrans website and you can download it for both Mac and PC. But let me show you exactly what I'm talking about and show you a demonstration of this. Start MobileTrans on your computer and connect your phone to the computer through its USB cable. Then, from the main interface, go to the top area and pick Phone Transfer, then iCloud to iPhone. Access your iCloud account and input the verification code that was sent to you. Then pick the iCloud data category you wish to recover. Then just select the files and click the Restore to Device option in the bottom right corner of the screen. Press the Start button and begin restoring iPhone data from the cloud. And once that's done, you can then disconnect your smartphone from the computer once the files have been restored. Apple ID controls everything that you do, from your books to your music and your photos. So an Apple ID is really a one device only thing. It's also a good idea to try and avoid using the same Apple ID on other phones, because like we mentioned in this video a few times, personal data can easily be transferred and you might not even know what they have on that phone. But if you do want to transfer data, then MobileTrans, remember, is the piece of software for you, because you can move your photos, videos, contacts, documents, music and all other data nice and easily with just a click. And that is it for today's video. If you enjoyed it, why not give it a like and subscribe to the channel as well. And remember, turn on that notification bell so you don't miss out on any of the videos that we have coming up, because we do hints and tips, unboxings of the latest devices, and our videos are always helpful for people that are in need. So if you subscribe to the channel, we will see you in the next video.